The Rams have the second best odds to win the NFC. So Von Miller, now a Ram, we could see clearly how much the city of Denver and playing for the Broncos meant to him right there. He's a baller, that's for sure. Stephen A., are the Rams now the team to beat in the NFC?
Swagoo. I'm going to have to say no at this particular moment in time.
Oh, Southern Steve is here?
I'm going to have to say that the Dallas Cowboys are the team to beat right now. I'm going to have to say that. I mean, again, you know what, we can get into specifics another day. But on this particular day, at this particular moment in time, you understand, week 7, week 8 of the NFL season 2021, the Dallas Cowboys are the team to beat.
Oh,
when you roll up in the Minnesota with a backup quarterback, and with a backup quarterback, you go and you win that game. When your defense rolls into Minneapolis, Minnesota, and they say, yo, we got to get this done because we don't have Dak. And they pull it off. I got to give love. I got to give love to Micah Parsons and his 11 tackles. I got to give love to Randy Gregory and the way that he's been balling. I got to give love to Trayvon Diggs, even though he gave up a pass to Thielen, but I won't hold that against him. The reality of the situation is that right now, the Dallas Cowboys have not one, but two players that are making the run for Defensive Player of the Year honors.
Oh, my goodness.
And when you take that into consideration, along with the pieces that they have in place without Dak Prescott, on this particular day, this particular week, I would have to say that my objectivity, my professionalism must take fold.
Very diplomatic on election day.
I must be able to do that, you know, on election day, because I'm a man of the people. I'm a man of the people. Yeah. The bottom line is, on this particular day, the Dallas Cowboys should be deemed the team to beat in the NFC.
Oh my God. I don't have to do TV the rest of the week. I don't need to do anything on this network the rest of the week. I've heard. Listen, hey, I feel like Dr. King right now, Stephen A., when he say he's seen the mountaintop, man. Like, I just never thought that I would sit on this show and hear that type of analysis come from Stephen A. Smith about the Dallas Cowboys. Listen, man, I'm a relish in this. I'm not going to ruin this by saying anything. I'm a relish in the fact that right now he's acknowledged that the Dallas Cowboys are the better team in the NFC right now. I'm going to just leave it there, okay. Molly.
That's
Molly.
Fine. No, it's cool.
Clip it.
Jeff Saturday just walked in.
He wants to
join on this. It's a good old time here.
I just walked in on Stephen A. preaching, and Swagoo's over there. He's feeling it. The Holy Ghost is on him.
Everybody. Can I get an amen?
You know what I mean? Like, it was just, like, you could feel it in the room. And then I just got to thinking, did Tom Brady retire?
Did Tom Brady retire?
No,
Last time I checked, we still got to do to the NFC that takes two hands to a whole. And the situation is fluid.
It's
today for the man of the people. Today is the day.
That's right.
Recency bias, all the things that go in there that are applied. Tom Brady ain't retired, folks. Don't ever buy into that. He played bad against New Orleans. I see it. I feel it. I'm with it. We can't just jump off the Bucs train right now. This early. Cowboys, Dak didn't even play last week. We got Cooper Rush who plays. They beat the Vikings. And we're all saying, listen, I love the Cowboys.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
but man,
my God.
You got sway. I think it's swagoo in your ear.
Not at all.
This entire season.
Wait.
I think it's just worn you down.
Not at all.
See, you know, it's like
unbelievable.
You know?
Wait, you go out on a limb and your timing's not even right.
Let me interject.
Poor
timing.
Let me interject.
With all due respect, you know what? I didn't know we were going to get into this right now. You understand what I'm saying?
Well,
I mean,
you
that's
went
not, I mean,
there.
I'll talk to the producers later. You asked the question. I'm answering the question. Okay? The point that I'm trying to make to you is this. It is election day. You see how I'm holding up my hand? It is election day.
Yeah.
And so when you think about being a man of the people, and you think about being a man of the people, and you have to have some level of objectivity. You understand fluidity comes into the equation. And just because I tell you that they're the team to beat, you understand right now in the NFC, you don't know what my A-list is going to look like.
Oh, no.
That's coming up.
So let's
be very clear.
Sometimes talking out of both sides of your mouth on election day.
Hey, listen, you know that's right.
Too.
That's true. That's what it is.
And say, this is what Jeff Saturday just did. This is what you just did, Jeff Saturday.
Let me hear.
The man is up there giving a good sermon, and you one of them members of church sitting in the back talking about, he ain't right. He ain't right, girl. He messing with the people that go to church. He just want to steal our money. He's selling books. Selling tape. You one of them members of the congregation. Jeff Saturday, let the man preach and tell the truth.
Music
and don't
right.
come in here talking about
well,
Tom
let me say this
Brady.
To you.
No.
Let me say this to you. Being a man of the people, there are certain facts that need to be spewed.
Okay,
here's one of them. Tom Brady didn't look that great Sunday against those New Orleans Saints. Number two, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and Tom Brady lost to the New Orleans Saints again, who did not have Drew Brees.
Right.
And by the way, didn't really have Jameis Winston because, God bless him, I hope he gets better soon, but the torn ACL and the MCL, really, really sad that happens. They lost Tom Brady and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, the reigning defending Super Bowl champions, lost to Trevor Siemian.
Yeah.
Now, I understand that Trevor Siemian has been in the league quite a while, and I'm not trying to throw any shade on them. And we know it's about that defense more than anything else.
For sure.
But again, when we take fluidity into consideration, and we combine that with the fact of how you just looked this past weekend, okay? I'm not saying that you're wrong with your argument when all is said and done, Jeff Saturday. Right. But this ain't the day to bloviate about the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
That's the difference between I'm staying strong. I'm staying strong.
Yeah, you got to.
Because here's what happened. Last year, how many times did the Saints beat the Bucs?
Twice.
Two.
And they lost to the playoffs.
When it mattered.
Okay.
Okay. All right. So.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.